Okay, hi again guys, what's up? Alright, so we will cover the next part of the engine system for water purification part 2. Right, so previously we discussed on the on this chapter 4 on a general water treatment process, aeration and also solid separation. So we know that in some solid separation they will have a settling type, okay, type 1 until type 4. Okay, so it's a huge topic for settling operation. So the second part I will discuss on the type 1 settling. So still continue on type 1 settling for solid separation. Okay. So previously we use terminal velocity, which is Stokes' law, to describe the terminal velocity. But what if let's say we have a water sample, so we wanted to design a settling column in order to treat the wastewater sample. So imagine this is like a big like a cylinder, a huge cylinder like the one in the lab. Okay, so it is an indirect method to measure the settling velocity. Okay, because most of the time we don't know what the velocity, settling velocity of certain particle. Mostly we will not know. Okay, so a suspension to be tested in is placed in this column. Okay, so it will mix completely to ensure uniform distribution of particle. So we have here the sampling port. Okay, so this is Z naught, is distance travel to sampling port. So this is the water level. Okay, so at time zero, some portion of the sample would be withdrawn out. Okay, and then again, it will make the suspension to settle, and the intermittent the sample will be withdrawn from the settling column at certain time interval. Okay, so the next thing happen, okay, we can calculate the velocity of every point in the settling column. So the first point is at the surface, which is this part, right? So we have velocity is equals to Z naught over T naught at T equals as time that initially taken the sample. Okay, so the same formula will be applied to determine at any point of this column. Okay, all right, so we use this formula. Okay, so you should have highlight this formula. Okay, okay, so this is the important formula that you will need to use in order to design the column. Right, if you refer to the figure 4.5 in your textbook, this will describe the same thing. Right, so the next one, when you have that for every point, okay, you will have the concentration for every point. Okay, every point meaning let's say at this point it will take out some water, and then it will start giving you a different x. Okay, different x because, okay, if you look here, right, if you refer to your textbook, okay, so your textbook page 118, so your x is actually, okay, your x is actually the concentration that you withdrawn, like Ci over C naught, the total C naught that you collect from T equals to zero. Okay, so later on, okay, you will plot a graph, okay, for this curve. It will produce this kind of curve. Okay, so it will be proportion of particle with less than stated settling velocity, which is this is the x part, okay, for y axis, and this one is the settling velocity. Okay, so this is actually, okay, the settling velocity, okay, v is actually we get it from z over T. Depends lah. If it's initial, then Z naught over T naught, and then Z1 over T1. So you will make plot. Okay, so You may refer to example 4.2 in page 119 for sample of calculation. I also have made a video on how and on describing on how to, you know, to solve this example 4.2 in a separate video. Okay, right. So your point later on, you need to solve, you need to calculate this part, okay, this part of your graph, okay, so that you will know either what is the time or what is the velocity, okay, so or the removal efficiency, okay, if using you know, such height column and such concentration of your sample, you may know what on how big is your settling column will be, right? So later I will explain more on example 4.2. Okay, next. So we go to the type 2 sedimentation. Just now we have 4, right? So I've covered type 1 and now it's type 2. So not all particles or flocculating particles can use Stokes equation, okay, because the particles continually changing size and shape. So analysis performed in column at least 300 mm in diameter. So and then sample are withdrawn at regular time interval from multiple pots or different sampling height. So the removal is plotted as a numerical value against the depth and time. So this is a different thing, okay, where this is to describe the type 2. Okay, so from the plot removal at various time, the theoretical efficiency is predicted. So you will know from the graph that you plotted, so such height of the column can be what is the removal efficiency of the settling column can do. Okay, so this is how analysis of settleability. Okay, so you have this column. Okay, if Stokes law, okay, you will take from the bottom, right, in type 1, but in this type 2 we'll take at the each every part of the every height of the column, okay, determine interval height. Okay, so you will withdraw the sample at every sample pot at selected time interval CT. Okay, and then calculate the percentage of removal using this formula. So this formula is actually shown in the textbook. Okay, okay, but it's actually a typical formula for removal. Okay, and then plot the x at depth versus time graph. Okay, and then from the analysis you can determine the effectiveness of the tank at selected time based on the flow rate, and then the height or depth of water, okay, and also the area, okay, the area of the column. Okay, so this is actually is being shown in example 4.3 in your textbook page 121. This is example of how you can settle how high, how big your settling point and settling column and what is the removal. Okay, this is to solve for type 2 settling operation. Okay, you need to plot this graph. Okay, so this for example 4.3, okay, I will also explain in a separate video. Then this is just to show you what kind of question that can be asked. Okay, so this is quite complicated as well. Example 4.2, example 4.3 is quite complicated, so that's why I have make it in a separate video to explain to you on this. Okay, so example 4.3, the following table gives the sampling concentration for a type 2. So it is already, you know, being highlighted type 2. Okay, and then column analysis. The initial, so that's why you will use this this method to design the column. Okay, the initial solid concentration is, this is your C0 lah, What is the overall removal efficiency? So required overall efficiency, giving you already the height of the settling basin, which is 3 meter. And the time, the detention time in order to achieve such conversion or removal is 1 hour and 45 minutes. This is equivalent to 100, if I'm not mistaken, it's 105, isn't it? Wait. 60, yes, 105 minutes. Okay, all right. So it will give you this data at 0.5. Okay, meaning that from the data 0.51. So this is at time sampling. So you will withdraw liquid from that point. So this one will be your concentration of it. Okay, so this will be 133.83. okay, so this result is actually the one in this one is actually concentration, this is all, this is concentration. Okay, concentration, it's C, whereas it will be drawn at certain times and certain depth. Okay, so the solution will be something like this. So I will explain more later, but first you determine the x. Okay, and then it will be if you look into this solution, if you can understand. Okay, but in the next video we'll go one by one of this. Okay. Alright, I think that's all for this video. We'll send you some the video on explaining example 4.2 and 4.3. Thank you.